Good morning friends, we are with a new topic, starting with a new topic that is corrosion control under corrosion module 2. Okay, so previous class we learnt about the factor affecting the rate of corrosion, and here we will be discussing about the corrosion control. Under corrosion control, we will be discussing in this today session about the metallic coatings. What is corrosion control? Corrosion can be controlled by using the following methods. They are metallic coatings, inorganic coatings, and by cathodic protection. Let us see what is a metallic coating. Deposition of a metal layer on the surface of a base metal. Okay, always the base metal we are referring to as a iron. Okay, iron will be coated with any suitable metal to protect against the corrosion. Okay, these are called as a metal coatings. There are mainly two types of metal coatings. They are anodic metal coating, example galvanization, and cathodic metal coating, example is a tinning, dear friends. What is anodic metal coating and what is cathodic metal coating? Let us discuss in brief. Anodic metal coatings are coatings which are anodic to the base metal iron. Anodic to coating of iron, the base metal. Example, you know, if you take iron in the electrochemical series, the metal which are present above to iron in the electrochemical series are anodic to iron. Getting no, you take any metal which is present above to it in the electrochemical series, okay, and you are coating with them. That is anodic metal coating. For example, aluminium, magnesium, zinc, cadmium, okay, they all are present above to iron in the electrochemical series. So if you coat with any of these things on iron, it is called as a anodic metal coating. These metals are present above in the electrochemical series or galvanic series and undergo corrosion, thereby protecting the cathode iron. You know this, no? Whenever you take two metals in the electrochemical series, the metal which is present above is always anode and will get corroded, and the metal which is present below to it will be always acting as a cathode and will get protected, right? Okay, so that procedure we are following here. So the anodic metal coatings are the metal coatings. Okay, when you take iron, you coat iron with any of the metals which is present above to it in the electrochemical series. Clear? And what is cathodic metal coatings? Cathodic metal coatings are the metal coatings which are cathodic to the base metal. What is the meaning here, dear friends? You take any metal which is present below to it, below to iron in the electrochemical series. Okay, iron is there. Below iron, whichever the metals are there. Okay, you coat iron with the metals which is present below to it. Okay, like example, coating of tin, nickel, chromium and copper on iron. Okay, coating by these metals on iron is a cathodic metal coating, which are present below to iron in a galvanic series. The coating is given in such a way that applied coat completely covers the metal surface, okay, without leaving even a pin holes. Otherwise, what happens? There will be a formation of a smaller anodic area and a larger cathodic area, and the rate of corrosion will be taking place at a faster rate. Okay, so in the cathodic metal coatings, dear friends, we should take care so much, like not even a pinhole area is left out of a tin coating. If it is left out, or if area is peeled off from a tin coating, corrosion will be taking place at a faster rate because of the formation of a smaller anodic area and a larger cathodic area. Yeah. Next, let us discuss the anodic metal coating in detail. Anodic metal coating example is galvanization. What is this galvanization? The process of coating zinc on the surface of iron is known as galvanization. Remember, dear friends, this is anodic metal coating. We are choosing a metal which is present above to it in the electrochemical series. Okay, so zinc is present above to iron. Zinc electrode potential is -0.76 and iron electrode potential is -0.44. okay, so zinc is coated on iron. Galvanization is an example for anodic metal coatings. The process of galvanization is as follows. Okay, how to do the galvanization? Okay, your no first article to be galvanized is cleaned with an organic solvent to remove oil, greases and other organic impurities if they are present. Okay, so first what is to be done? The metal to be galvanized is cleaned with an organic solvent to remove organic impurities like oil, greases, etc. Okay, and next step is the metal is to be treated with dilute acids like either with HCl or H2SO4. Here, no, when we treat with HCl or H2SO4, what happens? The scale like impurities, if they are present, they will be removed. Okay, and then now to get a smoother surface, the metal is to be coated with ammonium chloride and zinc chloride. Then the article is to be dipped in a molten zinc, which is kept at a temperature of around 430 to 475 degrees centigrade. Okay, and the excess zinc is to be removed by passing in between the rollers. Okay, galvanization is a safe and efficient. It is because of the factor according to which rate of corrosion is less if anodic area is large and cathodic area is small, dear friends. Okay, we are telling many times the same thing because it is very important to remember. Here what happens, when you coat zinc on iron, if a small area get damaged or filled off, what happens? There will be a formation of a larger anodic area and a smaller cathodic area. So the rate of corrosion will be always lesser. Okay, so the process of galvanization is like this. Okay, the iron sheet to be coated, no, it should be first treated with an organic solvent, then it is treated with dilute acid like HCl or H2SO4, then to get a smoother coating, it is coated with zinc chloride and ammonium chloride, then it is treated with molten zinc, which is in between the temperature of around 430 to 475, and the excess zinc is removed by passing in between the rollers. And then what are the applications of this galvanized sheets of iron, dear friends? It is used in protecting roofing sheets, wires, pipes, nails, bolts, bucket, etc., which are used in industries. It is also used in many electrical appliances. Fine. And cathodic protection is not there in our syllabus. Okay, only you should know what is cathodic protection. Tinning is no more there. So galvanization, that is anodic metal coatings, is over, dear friends. Okay, as always, go through the electrochemical series to remember. Okay, see here, iron is there. Iron is coated with the precious metals which is present above is a anodic metal coating. And if iron is coated with the metals which is present below to it, will be the cathodic metal coating. Okay, so anodizing is a coating zinc on iron, dear friends. Okay, zinc on iron, if a layer is peeled off, if a pinhole head area is left out of a coating, corrosion will be spreading at a slower rate. Clear? Okay, so with this, we are stopping the session, dear friends. Okay, we will be meeting shortly with a new session. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.